Hi, everybody. My name is Brenda Tringali. I'm a professional organizer and owner of At Your Fingertips Organizing. Here's yet another one of my tips to help you get and stay more organized and productive. This week, I'm talking about goal setting to help you get more focused. So I've already given you step one, which was to do a brain dump of the different goals you might possibly want to achieve. Yesterday's homework was step two. I told you to narrow down to the one goal that you think you would like to achieve first. Today, I'm talking about step three, and that is for you to convert that goal into a SMART goal. If you don't know what that is, it's an acronym that was actually developed by Peter Drucker back in 1954, and let me tell you what the acronym stands for. So the S stands for specific, so make your goal as specific as possible. The M stands for measurable, so you want to be able to measure the goal so that you know if and when you achieved it. The A stands for acceptable, so you want to make sure that your goal is feasible in terms of the resources available to you. The R stands for realistic, so you want it to be a realistic goal that you can really achieve. And then last but not least, the T stands for time-bound, which means to give yourself a deadline. So let me give you a comparison between a not-so-smart goal and a SMART goal. So a not-so-smart goal would be, I want to organize my paperwork. Okay, very general. So what are the problems with that goal? Number one, it's unclear what the word organize means. I can't picture that. Two, there's no vision of the end result, so you won't know what success looks like if you achieve it. And three, there's no deadline associated with it. So now I'm converting that into a SMART goal. Listen to the difference. So the SMART goal is I want to go through the unorganized 12-inch pile of papers in the left-hand corner of my desk by Saturday, March 28th, and organize them in folders by the action required until the pile is completely gone. Wow, that's a SMART goal. Now, so what are the benefits of going through this process? So number one, you will have thought through the process and defined what the word organize means to you. Two, you'll have a vision of what the project looks like when it's completed. And three, you'll have a deadline associated with it. So that is it for today, my friends. If you have questions, please comment below or reach out to me. If not, tune in tomorrow when I talk about step four of goal setting, and we'll be halfway there. And please, if you know of others who could benefit from my videos, please share this, and please know that I'm so grateful to you for sharing and for all of your support. I really appreciate it. I will see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye.